What's up and how's it going? Another day, another gameplay commentary by your boy, it's Gyro the console scrub himself. And today we're going to be playing some Rush Attackers on Death Valley for the Armored Kill DLC on the Xbox 360. We're playing as attackers, and as you can see, I'm already up in the AC-130 gunship. Give me that level 79 dice, I will take it, thank you very much. I'm getting so close to hitting that level 100 colonel, and with a premium double EXP starting tomorrow on Friday, we are all going to be leveling up so fast. And for any of the people that might complain about their score per minute being lowered by armored kill because of the lack of points that you per se get as fast as playing Operation Metro Conquest back to back to back to back to back, you know, of course your score per minute's going to drop. So hopefully this double EXP will help some of those people that care so much about their 1200 score per minute, you know, rating. So other than that, let's just talk a little bit about the gameplay and a little bit about Rush and Armored Kill. Now, as you all know, I play on the Xbox 360, so that's console gameplay. We only have 12v12, so that means PTFOing in Armored Kill is that much more important on console than I would say it would be on PC. On PC, you guys have it lucky of 32 versus 32. So any one person really doesn't have to become that super tryhard because you have 30-something odd people on your team that are usually going to pick up and realize what's going on. So console, it's different. We only have 12 people, so if we have 4 to 5 people that are being campy fucking noobs as recons or just being fucking derp-a-derps, you know, it really makes that other part of the team have to work that much harder and do that much more just to get that win up out of the game. Now, I was lucky enough to be on a team in this game for Death Valley on Rush that was quite good, and I'm not saying that the defending team was a bad team, because they were not a bad team and they were not bad players. It's just that AC-130 does create havoc. And as you will see throughout the video, I get into it 2 different times. You guys have already seen me get in it once, and I got about 6 kills, and then I jump into it a little bit later in the game here. And it only is up for a minute or two. Now that is because the defending team is doing the right thing of, you know, paying attention to the AC-130. That thing will create havoc and destroy your whole team if you're not careful. What a crappy team kill if you ask me right there. Sorry, apple pies, my bad. But like I was saying though, so it would seem like that the AC-130 for Rush for me is more like overall or less a big ass distraction for the defending team, because as you all know, it probably will not be up for very long because the Iglas and Stingers have been buffed so much. They have an insane range and they just fucking, everybody uses them. I'm using them right now too, just because I want to try to get my mastery dog tag on them, because I know that they're going to nerf them soon enough once again. So, like I was saying, the AC-130 is pretty much a distraction type of, like, vehicle for Rush, because if the defending team is smart and is, on to what's going on into the game and being observant, you know, they are going to know that you got to take out that AC-130, because if you don't take it out, it is going to spawn rape that defending team until no end. Now, as you can see here, we're already getting locked onto, flaring out, all that, still getting kills, but as you can see, they're still dominant on us. Now, with the AC-130 being a distraction type of, like, vehicle for Rush, I would say, it allows the ground forces of the map to be able to push in easier without having everybody be looking at them, because we gotta, like, worry about the guys coming to get the objective. Now, whenever you have a gunship up in the air and it's raining fucking hell from, like, above, that is your priority to get. So if you jump into that gunship, be sure to just make fucking lots of noise, kill lots of people, because you will be taken down. Don't bail out of it. Let those people get their kills, you know? Don't be a fucking sissy. So other than that, you know, I would say that I've been just thoroughly enjoying Armored Kill more and more, just as long as people play that objective. You know, if they don't play that objective, then of course the games are boring and we're sitting here base raping. But to be honest, I've yet to be in very many games like that, so that's not anything that I'm too like worried about. I would probably say once people get more comfortable with playing the maps and have a lot more of the attachments and unlocks unlocked for the brand new vehicles like the mobile artillery and tank destroyer, then you know they will get more into the campy state of mind. On that note though, I also did unlock all of the unlocks and attachments for the tank destroyer and also got my mastery dog tag with this awesome little tank thingy, tank destroyer here. The very, very last unlock that you get for it, I think, is reactive armor, which is quite funny because that is probably the main used thing in tank superiority now for me is guided missile, reactive armor, and then smoke. Those are my three choices. I will be putting out a tank superiority gameplay probably tomorrow with a commentary on that. If you guys enjoyed them, be sure to click that like button below. Tell me what your favorite game so far has been and how many kills have you gotten total in a game. Now be sure to comment below and say how many tickets that was also, because you know you can't say, well, I got 172 kills but it was a 1,000 ticket game, because that don't count. But if you guys also enjoyed, then be sure to click that like button and follow me over Twitter. I'll see you later.